Hello friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Amplifier. And in my this particular video, I am going to discuss some very important disadvantages of decision tree. And from this particular topic, many interview questions are frequently asked in the machine learning and data science related placement process also. Okay, so try to understand this particular disadvantages of decision tree very clearly. Okay, because sometime in interview this type of questions might be formed, like suppose you are trying to explain one project where you have used something belonging to tree family, and then the interviewer might ask that why you have chosen this and how to overcome the disadvantages, like that many questions can be formed, right? So let us try to understand some very important major disadvantages of this decision tree. Okay, although it is very powerful, many advantages of decision tree are present, like it reduces multiple data pre-processing, like categorical data handling, null value handling, right, feature scaling, all these things we no need to perform in decision tree, but it has its own disadvantage. And here is the first disadvantage, very important disadvantage, and that is decision boundaries are parallel to the axis, which I have already discussed in my previous video, right? It is our decision boundary in case of decision tree always parallel to the axis, and that creates a huge problem. Consider this particular distribution of data. Okay, here this data, which are belonging to one particular class, which is shown using green color, and here are some data points which are belonging to another class, which are denoted by gray color data points. Okay, now see, they are perfectly linearly separable, but how the separation line or decision boundary or hyperplane is, it is nothing but diagonal, right? Now in this kind of situation, decision tree never works properly. Okay, because if you want to create decision surface using decision tree, then multiple split it has to implement to separate these two class. You can see this kind of decision boundary it has to create. And then also these red data points, which are basically lying on this diagonal part, will be misclassified. Like you can see that this particular red data point, it is quite clear that it should belong to this particular class, right? From the visual inspection itself, we can conclude that this particular data point should belong to this gray class. But it is actually, if you apply decision tree, then it is coming under the split of the green region, right? The region belonging to green data. Similarly, this one, okay? You can see from the visual inspection, we can say that whatever trend the data has, according to that, this red data should belong to which category? This green class, right? But see, it is coming under the split of the gray color class, right? Similarly, this one is above this linear separator. So from the visual inspection, we can consider that this should come under this gray color. But see, due to application of decision tree, what it is happening, as the axes are parallel, so what this data point, how it will be classified? It will be classified coming under the green color class, right? So as the decision boundaries are parallel to axis, so if our data has diagonal separation hyperplane, that time it has to perform a huge computation to create the decision boundary for training data, and it, as well as it will perform misclassification. There is a probability that it will do misclassification for test data which are diagonally present, right? So one of the major disadvantages of decision tree is decision trees cannot learn diagonal decision boundaries, right? You have just now seen, I hope you can easily remember this from this visual demonstration, whatever just now I have shown. Then coming to the next very important disadvantage of decision tree, which I have already discussed in my previous video, why decision tree fails at high dimensional data, and that is multiple comparison, right? So for each split, decision tree has to basically compute multiple comparison, multiple values it takes from different variables, and try to find out the best split, right? The algorithm always try many combination of different variables to get the best split. Now, if you just think that if your data set size is very big, then huge combination, huge computational complexity will appear in the modeling of the machine learning model, right? So the decision tree is not at all suitable for large data sets due to multiple comparisons. Okay, and next very important disadvantage of decision tree is high variance, okay, and low bias also. That means very low error with respect to training data, but huge error with respect to test data, or in other words, we can say overfitting, right? Decision tree always suffer from overfitting. Okay, there is low bias, high variance will come in the picture of decision tree. Now you just try to think intuitively. Suppose you have created one model, decision tree classifier, which is a very huge depth. Okay, the depth of the tree is very high. That time what will happen basically? At each split, we are reducing the number of training data for each node, right? Now, you just consider if your depth of the tree is very high, that time the number of data points corresponding to each node will be very less, right? That means what I want to say that it might appear that at the leaf node, only one single data present. That means for satisfying the all the properties of training data, you are taking many decisions, okay, like this condition 1 and condition 2 and condition 3 and condition 4 and condition 5 and so on. Like that, you reached the training data. Now, this thing perfectly satisfy your training data, this thing perfectly reduce the training error, right? But this will never reduce the test data error, that is high variance you will be getting if you do like this. If you create your model like this, that's why maximum depth we have to control, minimum parent size, how many elements should present in leaf node, those things we need to control, right? So decision tree always suffer from overfitting, right? So these are three major disadvantages of decision tree. Number one is if our data is diagonally separable, right, that time decision tree might not work properly. Number two is it never work properly in very large data set because the computational complexity will be very high, many different combinations of different values it has to check to get the best fit model, and overfitting, right? So I hope you have understood this. So think twice before applying any particular machine learning model. What are the advantages, what are the disadvantages of those models you have to consider before applying any machine learning model to any new data set, okay? Because you just simply cannot put one particular algorithm, whatever you like or whatever you have studied in any data set, right? So try to understand the big picture and play with machine learning. Thank you.